Come on now, get up. It is today, folks. I'm coming right back at you. It's August 21st, 2016. Getting down to the final dog days of summer. Just cracked up another beer. After being hot as hell the last couple days, it's cooled down. When I woke up today, it was like 60 degrees. Why am I making this video? So it's good it's getting cooler. Why I'm making this video is because of this. This first edition Elemental Hero Rampart Blaster Ultimate First Dead from Elemental Energy. Look how sick that is. It's so mint. It's just like packed fresh. My local card shop had it and I had to pick it up, you know. Got a good deal. Rampart Blaster is a strange monster. But it's still cool. I like it. I love these Elemental Hero Ultimate Rares First Dead. I mean, they're so sick from that era, you know, like, oh, I guess from the Lost Millennium all the way up to, hell, I don't know when they ended. Enemy of Justice was one of the last good sets. And of course, there's my phone ringing for no damn reason. Let's take a look here who's calling. Who's unexpected on when. All right, I'm back. Mother Dearest called me asking if I needed groceries or anything. I don't know. 27 years old, I live by myself in my house in the woods, a four-bedroom house. Why she calls me and asks if I need her to buy me groceries is beyond me, because it's just loving mother. And I guess that's nice, but still, goddamn. Anyways, the real reason I'm making this video is for this. There's a third box of Dark Illusion I'm opening. I'm still on the box, a little beat up, but that card should be fine. I'm looking forward to getting... There's still two cards I haven't gotten. Well, I think there's actually three. Still two cards. Pot of Desire and Cosmic Cyclone. I still need those. And also, I have not gotten the other Subterra Behemoth, Umastrix, I think his name is. Have not gotten that yet. Don't make any sense why I don't have them. It's just an ultra rare. I mean, ultra rares are supposed to be easy to get these days. But let's, I'm going to rip this open right now. And I'm not looking forward to editing video. I got to edit, you know, so I didn't want my phone conversation call with mommy. And nothing serious. Just like I said, she wanted to know if she could buy me groceries. You know, I was like, why? Leave me alone. I'm busy opening Yu-Gi-Oh! All right, so here we go. Again, looking for that, the magical Pot of Desire. $50-something card. It's probably, well, I saw him strike out up there. It was like 80 bucks out of this the new way they do things. So, see if I can get one. Subterra Nemesis Warrior and Trimid Sphinx. Cool looking card. But yeah, I went to the Mariners game on Friday. They won. Good. I looked and they're only one game behind Wild Card right now. And hopefully they'll win. Hopefully Baltimore will lose again. Metal Foes Fusion. Yesterday I went and saw Suicide Squad with my good buddy the dog, Big Dog Danny. Check out his channel. He's got a good channel going. Danny's Rants and Reviews. I'll put that on the video description here. You know, so we can... you know, he does a good job reviewing, I think, and he's got a good sense of humor. Me and him have very similar senses of humor. Let's see, we got Tuning Gum and True King Agnimazud, the Vanisher. Another card that should have not been an ultra rare. Does this have nothing to do with even the Draco Lords? Maybe it doesn't. Maybe it's just some other random card. I don't know. I think that actually might be the first one that I've gotten. So I guess I still need Umastrix. But now I have that. I don't remember getting that card before. I know I've gotten Masterpiece. Peace, homie. That's what he always says. Masterpiece. Get it? It's kind of a, you know, it's a play on words there. Like Masterpiece. Like, I guess the, whatever. Ebon High Magician. What is that? Mona Lisa. Everyone's like, Mona Lisa's such good artwork. I'm like, what the hell? I don't know about that. Kind of an ugly woman. You know, I'm sure she looked better in real life than the painting. That's how it works, you know? People are always hella ugly in pictures. You know, you see a picture of them, you're like, ugh. And then you meet them, like, oh, they're not that bad looking. I don't know what it is about pictures. I know I'm one of the worst. People see me in pictures and like, Jesus Christ, you look terrible. Termit Hunter, Paleozoic, Animal Cross. You know, and, but, you know, some people do look better in pictures because that's a Hollywood, you know, where they spend like 7 hours doctoring the photo to make them look really good. Not that some of these people need help looking good, you know what I'm saying? It's like, dude, they already look fine. Why are you spending so much money? D7 Thomas and Metal Foes combination. This should be a spell card, not a trap card. It'd be so much better as a continuous spell. As a trap card, you gotta like set it. You gotta have like future vision. You know, you gotta set that thing and then next turn activate it while you fuse and summon a Metal Foe monster, which God knows if you're ever gonna be able to do that. I mean, just set that immediately. You know, it's the worst of the three. You know, current Metal Foe spell and trap cards we got, and then next set full Metal Foe's fusion comes out. Okay, going here, Acrobatic Magician. Oh, and I got it! The Pot of Desires! Finally, I got you, bitch! I found you! You were hiding in this beat up ass box! I got you! Where you been? Well, you're right here, right now. So I got you. Look at that, a Pot of Desires! Boom! Goddamn! Boom! Woo! Finally got you! How about that? Get on that. Get on that right now. I need to take a heavy sip of beer for that. Desire for the pot has finally been fulfilled. I finally got that bastard. Jesus Christ. I opened up 3 boxes and like half a box before I finally got that. Melfo's Crimsonite and Magician of Dark Illusion. I don't really know about Crimsonite. He's big, but he's useless. I built an entire Metal Foes deck, and I still haven't played it. Probably going to wait till after Labor Day, because I'm going to play Blue Eyes in Spokane. I'm going to... Yeah, this Washington's got 2 regionals announced so far. September 3rd for Spokane, and October 15th for Seattle. So... That'll be fun. Tyrant, Red Dragon, Archfiend. Not a very good Ultra, but still good artwork on it. Good artwork. I like it. It's like some sort of like Castlevania boss monster now. That's what they've turned to Wrecker Panda. That's all it is a red panda with vanilla. I guess it's really good for those raccoon decks. Amazing, for a while I was battling raccoons on my property here in the woods, and then I was also battling raccoons in Yu-Gi-Oh! Online and in the actual store. You know, like, god damn, I can't get away with these fucking raccoons. Just everywhere. Performable Gumguten and Magician's Rod. I don't know if they could have named that differently. Like, Magician's Staff, Magician's something. I mean, Marad, I mean, come on, that's just gonna... That's just asking for ridicule. Alright. It's a balloon taper. It's cool, I guess. Radish Horse. Trimet Pulse. It's actually the harder one to get, I think. And Metal Moor Formation. This is a terrible fucking card. Why did they ever print that? It's unknown to me. Like, who would ever use Metal Moor Formation? I mean, yeah, your monsters get 300 attack and defense. But it's just, it's not bad. I mean, it's playable, but it's just, it takes up deck space for better, that you could use with better cards. It's just, it's a joke. You know? Why do that? Alright. Halogenic, I love that name. I can't believe they kept it. Magical something. Something magical going on there. And Toon Dark Magician. This never happened in the anime, at least that I remember. Toon Dark Magician, but, you know, whatever. It's cool. I think it's a pretty good-looking Toon monster. Heavy Freight Train, Derek Crane. Snowplow Hustle Russell was reprinted for the first time ever. That was a pretty hard card to get, but now you can get a couple for box in Dragon Legends Unleashed. Which is always kind of sad, because, you know, that card was worth, like, $25 at one point. Probably still worth like 20 because it's so hard to find in its original print. Soyo the Rain Hider and Lunalight Perfume, which is a really good Lunalight card. Target one Lunalight monster in your graveyard. Special summon it. You can banish this card from your graveyard, then discard one card. Add one Lunalight monster from your deck to your hand. It's kind of a heavy cost, though. The discard. I don't think Lunalights discard like to discard from their hand, but what do I know? I've not played a Lunalight deck yet. Probably never will, because I can't go on DN anymore. I might have to look into trying Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro out or whatever it is. I gotta talk to... My computer's so slow and ancient, I don't think it can handle it. Trimid Sphinx, that's the second one of that I got in this box. Tuning Gum is one of the most hideous things I've ever seen. Like, I mean, look at this thing. Fuck, what the hell? Gross. You know, I thought they were done printing cards like that. Well, I guess they made all the Amorphage monsters, so... Whatever. Magician's Robe. So stupid they made Dark Magician's Clothes a monster card. They're running out of ideas. I guess they're running out of ideas or something. Metal Foe's Gold Driver. This is the hardest Metal Foe monster to get from all my recollection. Even guys I talked to in the shop. I did not play locals yesterday. I went down and saw Suicide Squad, which was hella good. I really enjoyed Suicide Squad. Not a masterpiece movie, but damn good. And a Subterra Behemoth Umastrix. There, I finally got one of these guys. Finally. I don't know what took so long. I've been getting the other one. I've gotten the other one like four or five times. Maybe he's still hiding in this box. But here we go. Got an Umastrix, folks. Life is good. Finally got one. It's not worth much money, like $4 or something. But still, you know, I got to get him to complete the whole fucking thing. So the last card I need is a Cosmic Cyclone. So now I will be on the search for that. Because I got Pot of Desire finally. Thank fucking God. Spiral Quick Fix and Spell Strider. Here is a Scape Ghost Coast to Coast. It's so weird. If you just change a couple letters right there, it becomes Space Ghost. They're going to have to do it sometime. Space Ghost. I'll look forward to that. They'll probably get sued and have to rip all the boxes of that set off the shelves. So if you get a hold of a Space Ghost Coast to Coast card, get a lot of money for it. It's just like the Dark Paladin. They got its artwork changed. Like, if you get the fixed artwork, it's worth like $800. I have the non-fixed artwork. It's only like $40-$50. Tribid Hunter and number 81, Super Dreadnought Rail Cannon, Super Dora the Explorer. You want another scapegoat ghost. I like his artwork. It's such cool artwork for such a shitty card. Like, I wonder if they can use it. It's a zombie and special summon zombie tokens. Five of them, potentially. I guess only four. I can only do four because it'll still be on the field and it gets flipped face up. So just four tokens. Alright, Magician's Robe. And Revolving Switch our Illusion Magician, or Illusion Magic. And Lunalight Perfume. I really like the artwork on Illusion Magic. He's like, no. It's like Tien Shinhan's one power in Dragon Ball, where he makes copies of himself. I guess Krillin and Piccolo did that against... What's his name? Nappa, which Nappa just obliterated them. What do they call that? I can't remember. I remember them both doing it, and Nappa's just like, I've seen this trick before, and he like just obliterates them, and he's like playing patty cake with them, it looks like. I haven't played patty cake myself in a long time. I don't think I'm ever going to ever again until I have like children of my own, which God knows that's ever happened. Trimid Master and Nirvana High Paladin. That's a sick secret right there. I love this monster. He's so cool. Look at him. He's got his hand outstretched, reaching for that steak. He's like, must eat beef. And just an odd monster because he's a synchro and a pendulum monster, which they've only done, I think they've only done once, not as a synchro, but they did with the Odd Eyes Rebellion Dragon. It is a XYZ and a pendulum. They've not done a fusion yet or a ritual, so we're still waiting on those. But still, what a good-looking monster. The cover monster of this set, Nirvana High Paladin. He's going to get high. He's going to listen to some Smells Like Teen Spirit. And he's going to be a paladin, which is a very fancy knight, by the way. That's what a paladin's like, the highest rank a knight can be back in the medieval times. That's a little bit of history for you there, kids. Paladin, now you know. Go home and impress your teacher, impress your mom. I guess impress your school bus driver. Probably just tell you to shut the hell up and sit back down in your chair. No seatbelts on school buses. I forgot about that. Been a while since I rode a school bus. DD Savant Thomas and Amaterasu. It's a spirit monster. I've gotten this card multiple times. I just realized it's a spirit monster. Very few spirit cards are ever printed. The most infamous, of course, being by far is Yatagarasu. Which, think the Yatagarasu and Chaos Emperor Dragon, Envoy of the End. We got the ban list, which is a good thing. I'm really glad that they implemented the ban list way back in 2004. Because, God forbid, if they didn't, we'd still be playing some of those decks getting wrecked. Let's see. Oh, Fairy Tale Snow. I think it's the first one I've gotten this. This is the hardest common to get. Trimid Cruiser and Subterra Behemoth Stalagmo. I knew he was sitting in the box. I knew he was hiding in there. I knew that he wanted me to pull him again. It's all right. Him and Shiranui Solitaire, I get all the damn time. All the damn time. But there it is. Subterra Behemoth Stalagmo. Oh, it wouldn't be Dark Illusion. I've gotten Subterra Stalagmo out of every box, I think, so far that I've opened. This is box number, what, 3 or 4? I opened one off camera just to go through it myself and read each card that I got. You know, that takes me forever. But still, I think I've gotten him. I may have not gotten him out of that box, but I don't know. But every box, I get that bastard. I think I did get him out of that box, I remember, yeah. Metal Foes Fusion, so I don't think I'm going to get Shiranui Solitaire. I think I might be out of Ultras and Secrets. I already got my 2 Secrets. I might have one more Ultra left in here. I don't know, we'll see. I got 2 packs left. There's another Ultra in here or another Secret. I'd be pretty stoked. Trimid Dancer. We got Metal Foes Volt Flame and Magician of Dark Illusion. That's a cool super there. It really should be kind of an ultra, but you know, they're trying to reduce rarities for decks, except for they didn't do it with Blue Eyes. I mean, think about the Blue Eyes cards. You got Dragon Spirit of White, which is an ultra. Same with Ancient White Stone, Sage with Eyes of Blue. Those are all ultras. And then Blue Eyes Spirit Dragon was a secret, so it's like they did not tone down the rarity at all for the Blue Eyes and Shining Victories, which is fine with me. I have that deck. I'm wrecking people with it a lot of times, except Counterfeiters. I can't beat Counterfeiters with it, which is really frustrating. But other than that, it's a gorgeous-looking deck. It's a Blue Eyes White Supremacist deck. You'll do a deck video on it sometime. Spiral Gear Big Red and Ebonhide Magician. Did not get another Ultra or Secret, which is fine. Let me see how many Ultras I got. I guess I'm supposed to get 4. I never actually keep track while I'm opening. I just throw them down this good old pile right here. So, let's go through it again. I got the Subterra Behemoth Stalagmo. I mean, come on. I need to get one of these every fucking box. If I don't get one out of Dark Illusion, that's a bad box. I guess Nirvana High Paladin. Love that. That's great. Great monster. Cool. Looks awesome. Let's see here. And then the Subterra Behemoth Umastrix. Always need one of them. You know, actually, the first one I've gotten is a reptile monster, too. So, oh, yeah, there's the little Subterra Nemesis Warrior. You know, he should be in every time they have one of these big monsters, which is going to be 3 more sets of, they need to have him in there. I might want to actually make Subterra Behemoths. I mean, I've got so many of their cards. I mean, I think I've got like 4 or 5. You know, I got 3 Hidden Cities. I want to see what the deck looks like. Tyrant, Red Dragon, Archfiend. And there it is, the Pot of Desires. Holy shit, I got one. It's got Pot of Greed and Pot of Avarice fused together. Banish 10 cards on top of your deck face down. Draw 2 cards. I've had people play this against me, and they lose or they win. Like, I've seen them straight up die from using this card, but I've seen them beat me with it. So it's really kind of is Pot of Desires. You kind of, you know, I need to win. Let me play this. And some, it's kind of like Reckless Greed, you know. And I should have one more in here. Yeah, there it is. True King Agnimizud, the Vanisher, which I guess has nothing to do with the other. I thought he had something to do with the Draco Overlords or whatever, but I guess not. So anyways, great box open because I get Pot of Desire. I could not get a Cosmic Cyclone out of the same box. That'd be the ultimate box. I get Cosmic Cyclone and Pot of Desire. But I did get Nirvana High Paladin, so I'm always stoked. Look, this card's got 6 wheels. It's got 3 axles. Why, I don't know. It's a good-looking car, though. It's almost as cool as Card D. But yeah, happy to get all these things. So guys, once again, thanks for watching. Once again, I'm going to plug my buddy, Danny's Rants and Reviews. Go check him out. He's got his newest videos about Suicide Squad, I believe. And check him out. Keep subscribing to me. Keep watching my videos. Spread the word. Let them know the main man's out. Let them know the main man just got a pot of desire. God damn. Anyways, guys, I'm getting drunk all the time. You know, I hope you all are too, but always drink responsibly. Please don't drink and drive. I know it's difficult to do. You got to get home and you feel all right. But you know what? If you got to and nobody can give you a ride at the bar, just lay down your car. Do not put your keys in the ignition. Put your keys in your pocket somewhere else. Lean back in the seat and sleep all night in your car. Trust me, it's worth it. It may sound stupid, whatever. Just do not get drunk and drive your car or operate any sort of machinery. Just do whatever you can do. If you're drunk, and even though you're thinking straight, your mind can't react as well, and your vision's a little messed up. So just lay down in your car and sleep. Just do it. I've done it. I think everybody who drinks has done something like that. You know, I don't really have anybody to pick me up or drive me around. So just always be safe while drinking. I drink. Probably a lot of you drink. Just always be safe. Anyways, guys, I'm getting drunk all the time. Hope you all are too. And I will catch you for the next video. Peace!